you find some lower but not bottom echelon that these characters, especially toward the end, start to embody, and that's their life.
Yeah.
It's not redemptive exactly. It's not castigatory either exactly. Nope, because nobody knows. They find a wavelength of their own that I think is their own. It's self-definable. It's what they are. And if the law doesn't catch you, are you a thief? You know, at the end of the day, after all is said and done. Well, I mean, they were, but on any given day, they still had to have lunch. You know, they were
that's right.
Regular people.
They still have to show up to work.
They do. And all in all, I mean, I think that's what happens here. And it's the great joy is that the regular has equal billing with, I think, the extraordinary here.
Thank you. And that was one of my goals as a writer, to sort of put my glamorous ideas or the more sparkling ideas about heists that we get from movies and books alongside the real mundane truth of our everyday lives, to force those things together to see them both much more clearly. That's my hope.
I don't think I'd have the guts to do it, by the way.
To have the guts to do something
to do
like
a
this?
Heist, yeah.
Me neither.
I'd be shaking like crazy.
Early on, when I was trying to write the crime, someone in one of my writing classes said, "You are not a criminal mastermind." That much is clear. and he was right, but I realized that I needed to make that a strength of the book, and it needed to be about that feeling of failure.
Which I think you did very well.
Thank you.